Ever since our existence, the moon has captured our interest. Decades ago, we ventured outside our atmosphere and landed on its surface. Since then, we have seen rapid advancements in technology, and space exploration is more promising than ever before. With the International Space Station nearing decommission, it poses the question, could one of our endeavours be to build a moon base? Many government agencies and private space companies have already proposed plans for a lunar base. NASA's interest in establishing a moon base has never waned. However, with political changes and unstable budgets, it has not been a priority. 2 years ago, the European Space Agency, or ESA, announced plans for building a permanent lunar base in the 2020s, called Moon Village. SpaceX has also shown interest, with Elon Musk stating it's 2017, we should have a lunar base by now. To have a permanent moon base, a crew would need food, water, shelter, and plenty of oxygen to survive. In the short term, this would mean transporting copious amounts of supplies from Earth. Compared to Mars and Venus, where interest is keen, it would be cost-effective. At 384,000 kilometers away, the moon is our closest celestial body. It may be our closest space neighbor, but with a lack of conditions to sustain human settlement, it's going to be difficult. The lack of atmosphere on the moon brings hazards from cosmic radiation to deadly micrometeorites. The temperature will also be a problem, changing from 120 degrees during the day to minus 173 at night. A moon base could serve as a launching platform or fueling station for future missions, and would be way cheaper than launching them from Earth. Rockets would take less fuel to launch due to a decreased gravitational pull, as the moon's gravity is 1/6 that of Earth. It would also provide a unique environment for scientific research and experiments. Rovers could be used to find a suitable location to set up such a base. They could also explore nearby resources, making it far safer and cheaper than humans. Although it is said what a rover can do in 10 years, an astronaut can do in a couple of hours. A key location might be underground in caves or lunar lava tubes, having natural protection from micrometeorites and cosmic radiation. Japan's JAXA spacecraft Kaguya first spotted an opening in the moon's Marias Hills region back in 2009. Further observation from NASA's Lunar Reconnaissance Orbiter revealed it to be 150 feet wide and deep, and 30 miles long, which would be more than enough room for a base. Another good location to set up would likely be at the poles, where sunlight is almost always present, and there is potential for water sources. NASA's satellites have already indicated that water ice might be present in shadowed craters that never see sunlight at the North Pole. In addition, India's upcoming mission, Chandrayaan 2, will be ready to orbit and launch a rover on the moon's surface this year. If successful, Chandrayaan 2 will be the first ever mission to land a rover near the lunar South Pole. This will reveal important scientific data on lunar topography, mineralogy, and signatures of water ice. Another valuable resource on the moon would be helium-3, which is in short supply on Earth. In most nuclear power plants, nuclear fission reactors are used, in which uranium nuclei are split apart, releasing energy and radioactive waste. Helium-3 has the potential to be used as a fuel in future nuclear fusion reactors, and would produce little radioactive waste. However, it's likely such a technology will not be available for at least another 50 to 100 years. One nation who are developing their space technology extensively is China, who have expressed their enthusiasm to mine this resource. However, the Outer Space Treaty signed in 1967 prohibits any nation from claiming territory in space or on celestial bodies, justifying that space and everything in it is the shared heritage of all mankind, which will surely go down well if we ever met with another intelligent civilization. Currently, the only reason to go to space is to launch satellites, make new discoveries, and carry out scientific research. No one has the technology to cheaply mine asteroids for resources, or set up a colony, and only a few billionaires can afford a trip around the moon. When a company or government agency find a way to make a profit from space ventures, this old Cold War treaty may be brought into question or discarded. But in the short term, a lunar base would likely be used like the International Space Station, a place built by all spacefaring nations and used in harmony. As for the construct of the base, solar panels would provide a power source and necessaries like construction. Communication would also need to come from Earth, which would be expensive. But companies like SpaceX are finding new and innovative ways to make space travel cost-effective, using renewable rockets like the Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy. The ESA are also working on developing technologies in 3D printing to better cope with the moon's environment. A lunar base could have a communication center, a research lab, and facilities and habitats for the people living there. Once everything is set up, a crew could be sent up to carry out research and experiments, but would also continue to work on the base. Astronauts and researchers at the lunar base would likely follow a similar routine to the International Space Station. Astronauts on board the ISS usually stay for around 6 months, with 3 to 6 crew members at all times. Although the American astronaut Peggy Whitson has spent 665 days in space. Astronauts can't really stay in space for prolonged periods, because at low levels of gravity, our muscles and bones change dramatically. On average, astronauts will lose more than 1% of their bone mass each month they spend in space. It's clear a colony on the moon is not suitable, but a base from which rockets can be launched and technologies tested, the future looks bright. Due to its short distance away, equipment and the building processes could be tested at minimum risk, providing useful experience and insights before our future endeavours to Mars and beyond.